I actually came across computer in 1999 by our uncle, and since then I've been fascinated about the computer. In 2013, I came back to Liberia. Fortunately, my sisters were doing business and they were going to Dubai buying electronics and selling these electronics to the army soldiers. But actually, they had a challenge. They were novice to the electronics gadgets. Most of these army soldiers, especially the Nigerian soldiers, they came from rural communities. So most of them, it was their first time being exposed to those technologies here. So I was also teaching them, installing for their apps, configuring their phones. So I was generating money through that. And one day I told my sisters, you know what? I want to open an internet cafe in this community. It was a community without electricity. There was no national electricity. So access to computer centers were very difficult. What if everybody in the center of the city know how to use technology? What will become of the people in the rural community? Are we going to leave them out? Are they not part of society? Do they have the right to learn technology? Do they have the right to access to technology? I have been with them. I've tried to give them access to the internet, but they don't understand the device. So we need to make them to have understanding of the device before they can know what the device is capable of doing. I was called from back home and was told that my lab was broken in. They took away my laptops. And close friends started calling me, "Oh, don't come, you know, stay there, you are already in America." And I told them, no. I was not dreaming to come to the States. What I was doing back home brought me here. And I think that if I do more, I can go to places. In every challenge, there's an opportunity also. Most times when you feel comfortable, you don't think out of the box. But when you are challenged most times, that's when you think out of the box the most. Because by then you are eager for solution.